Now our reconnaissance has spotted the Japanese task forces. This is the moment we've been fighting and praying for. Every plane that can fly and every qualified pilot is ordered into the air.
The Mustang, the P-51, the longest range fighter in the world. Speed, fast climb, quick dive, tight turn.
There was an American volunteer group in Asia. Here, special advisor to the Chinese Air Force, Claire Chennault, had 84 volunteer pilots, including men such as Tex Hill, George Burgard, and Robert Smith. Nicknamed the Flying Tigers, their P-40 Tomahawks were serviced by Chinese mechanics and 200 American ground crewmen.
Thank you.
For advanced training, we sent the fledgling flyer to nearby Kelly Field. There, he flew an AT-6. Although the 1939 Aviator was America's number one idol, no longer was he a one-man show. The leader and his wingmen were a team, pilot and air crew, flyer and ground crew. Because in this business, every man's life was always in the hands of a team.
Jungle, but the Sandy's job is to find him and fight him. Their aircraft, A-1Es, fly slow enough for the Sandy's to observe and slow enough to concentrate their firepower. They are armed with rockets, machine guns, 20 millimeter cannons, and bombs. We'll be right back.
first step was the construction of an air bridge across which supplies were to be flown by flyers of the American Transport Command, shuttling back and forth over what they called the hump. It was a slow process. Equipment had to be taken apart so that it could be loaded aboard planes. They made a sky bridge 525 miles long over the roof of the world and carried across in unarmed transport planes the vital supplies needed by the American and Chinese air forces and the Chinese armies.
The moon, but